this far. Believe me, the devil wants you to believe that your waiting, your patience, your faith is all in vain. But look at your neighbor and say, it's not in vain. Hallelujah. Clark sisters, you should say it best when they said, no, of course not. They said, is my living in vain? Is my singing in vain? Is my preaching in vain? And we say, and they said, no, of course not. It's not. It's not all in vain. They said, because up the road is eternal gain. Hallelujah. So today, young man, we say to you, we thank you for going out to represent us and Greater Love Community Church on this morning. And I know that you wrecked shop, didn't you? Now they know what a twerker really is, don't they? Hallelujah. So without further ado, stand your feet all over the building. Let's receive him, our very own. How are you, Pastor Mason Payne Brown?
Greater love. Amen. I'm excited to see you all.
Yeah.
To come and hear the word of God, not the word of man.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Look at your neighbor and tell them, I'm excited to see you today. Amen. Come on, let's all bow our heads for prayer. Oh Lord, we thank you this morning. We love you. We want more of you. Father, put a love in our hearts to love you more and to love our neighbor. Father, let the words that come out of my mouth be filled with love and compassion and full of Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Father, we need you this morning.
Yes.
Let these words be anointed by you, Jesus.
Yes.
Let them not see me, but let them see Jesus. Father, don't let them see me at all. It's not about me. Holy Spirit, let's glorify Jesus this morning. Let's give him all the glory. Now, Father, we thank you. We love your son. And it is in Jesus' name we pray and ask it all.
Amen.
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 Turn your Bibles with
teach us,
to Matthew
teach us.
Chapter 8. Starting at the verse 5. Matthew chapter 8. Verse 5. Is there anybody with pain in their right shoulder? Right shoulder. We are healed if that's you on Facebook Live.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 8, verse 5. Not that not be before you too long. Amen. When you have to say amen.
Amen.
The word of God says, and when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, there came unto him a centurion, beseeching him, and saying, Lord, my servant lieth at home, sick of the palsy, grievously tormented. And Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. For I am a man under authority, having soldiers under me. And I say to this man, go, and he goeth. And to another, come, and he cometh. And to my servant, do this, and he doeth it. When Jesus heard it, he marveled and said to them that followed, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. And I say unto you, that many shall come from the east and the west, and shall sit down with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. But the children of the kingdom shall be cast out into the outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And Jesus said unto them and to the centurion, go thy way, and as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. And this servant was healed, and his servant was healed in the same hour. I'm going to read that one more time, verse 13. It says, and Jesus said unto the centurion, go thy way, and as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. And his servant was healed in the same hour. Amen. Look at your neighbor and tell them, Jesus, take a chill pill. Say it one more time, Jesus, take a chill pill. You may be seated. Amen. Look at your neighbor and tell them, baby, let Jesus chill for a minute. Jesus, chill for, y'all sound dead up in here. Look at your neighbor and tell them, baby, let Jesus chill for a minute. Come on, I need somebody that's alive. But look at your neighbor and tell them, arise from the dead.
Arise from the dead.
Y'all talking back to me. Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Come on, Mason, come on.
In 2017, many of you had thought that everything was going to have some change in it. Amen. But if someone can just be real for just a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
If someone would just let somebody taste a little sip of that Kool-Aid, they'll probably die from it.
Yeah.
Because what you thought was Kool-Aid was some poison.
Oh, all right.
You ain't talking back to me. Look at your neighbor and tell him, you've been drinking some poison. In 2017, you thought that you was walking with God, but the veil was removed and you've been walking with Satan the whole time. Y'all ain't talking back to me. You've been walking with Satan and you thought you was walking with Jesus. And some of y'all been posting on Facebook talking about 2017 is my year. 2017, I'm going to be stress-free. 2017, I'm going to get my new, what y'all call that weed, that she's happy hair. I'm going to get my new she's happy hair. I'm going to get a new car. I'm about to be stress-free this season. But to be honest, if you can just be real for a minute, you was lying the whole time. Because if some of us can just share a sneak peek into our present life, you probably wouldn't even want to deal with me right now. You probably even wouldn't even want to talk to me right about now, because all along I've been living a lie. My life has been full of some lies. I've been faithless in this season. My faith has been low. It used to be God shall supply all of my needs, but now you're thinking God used to supply all of my needs. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Some of your faith has been low in this season. Y'all ain't talking back to me. But if I can just get two or three people that can be real and tell somebody that you don't know like I know. You don't know my story. You don't know what I had to go through. You don't know all the sleepless nights I had to go through. You don't know all the times I had to lie to my children and tell them that it's going to be all right, but it really wasn't going to be all right. Look at your neighbor and tell them, stop lying to yourself. I've been faithless. Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Come on.
Your faith used to be so good that you wasn't even tripping about the bill that you need to be paid the next day. But now you're on the street asking for some money. Some of you have been asking God, where are you? And it seems like Jesus has blocked you from calling his phone. Right now, some of your hearts have been telling God, you see me in this hell, please come and take me out. Some of you are having one of those I need thee, oh Lord, moments. But baby, I've got some good news, because we serve a God that will pick you up and turn you around. Place your feet on solid ground. Look at your neighbor and tell them that this is your breakthrough season. This is your season that's full of faith and not of misfortune. Y'all are talking back to me. Look at your neighbor and tell them, arise from the dead. Tell the preacher, I don't mean to look at you crazy. I don't mean to look at you crazy. Y'all ain't talking back to me.
All right.
One thing I like about this text is the opening, because the writer had the nerve to start off the text with the words, and when Jesus was entered into Capernaum. Y'all ain't catch the revelation. The text said, and when Jesus entered into Capernaum. And I just want to prophesy to somebody that God is getting ready to walk into your situation. God is getting ready to walk into your 2017. What you thought was bad is about to turn into good, because Jesus is about to become your solid rock, which you stand on. Look at your neighbor and tell them that Jesus is walking into my life in 2017. Jesus is walking into my life in 2017. I don't care what you've been looking at. I don't care how it seems. But Jesus is walking into your 2017. I need somebody to wake up this morning. In our text today, we are witnessing a centurion come on the behalf of his servant. And his servant was suffering from being paralyzed and in terrible pain. But what's interesting about this man's testimony is how he got this testimony. And many people in this season are searching for the element to build their faith in this season. And I believe that this man's story will help you in this season. And what's so interesting about the story is how the centurion got his servant healed. And the centurion teaches us three things in the text. And the first thing he teaches us is that you've got to humble yourself.
Yeah.
And look at verse 5 through 7. It says, and when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, that came unto him a centurion beseeching him, and saying, Lord, my servant lieth at home of the palsy, grievously tormented. And Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. Look at your neighbor and tell him, you've got to humble yourself. People of God, in order for you to understand what I'm talking about, you've got to understand the people in the text. You've got to understand who the centurion is. The centurion was a Roman officer. And at the time, the Romans and the Jews were not friends. And the Romans and the Jews did not like each other.
The Jews did not
like that the Romans were their oppressors. And in that day of time, it wasn't normal to come and ask a Jew for some help. See, you've got to understand that the Roman officer didn't have to go to Jesus concerning his servant that was paralyzed. The Romans had the best of the best. They had every solution to every problem. They had every medicine they needed for any medical issue. But this time, it was different, because the Romans could not meet his demand. He couldn't fix it this time. He couldn't rely on his own strength this time. And I want to tell somebody this morning that God will get you to a place where all you got is Jesus. God will get you to a place where you can only rely on the Lord. And some of y'all done searched all over but can't find nobody. You done looked high and low but still can't find nobody. Y'all ain't talking back to me. God will get you to a place where all you got is the Lord. But I just dare somebody to look to the hills from which cometh your help. I just dare somebody to come to the master's feet. I just dare somebody to forsake your way and come unto Jesus. See, many people think that Jesus doesn't answer their prayers, or he doesn't hear their prayers. But I come to tell you that that's all a lie. The problem is not Jesus. The problem is us. The problem is with you, is that you're so prideful. If you are taking notes, write this down. See, pride pushes you away from Jesus. How you say that, preacher? Well, don't you remember, Satan wanted to be equal with God.
Right.
And since that that desire was in his heart, he got kicked out of the presence of God.
Right.
And only because this thing called pride was in his heart.
Right.
Pride drives you away from the presence of God. See, the reason your faith is so low is because your pride is too high.
That's
some revelation. But humility draws you closer to Jesus.
Yeah.
Why you say that, preacher? Because in Isaiah chapter 57, 57 verse 15, it says that God dwells in a high and holy place.
Right.
With him are also this of a contrite and humble spirit.
Yeah.
Then Psalm 138 verse 6 says, though the Lord be high, yet hath he respect unto the lowly. The pride he knoweth afore. See, the Roman officer's pride could have kept him away from Jesus.
Yeah.
But he made up in his mind that I'm going to have to give up all of this pride and get on my knees and beseech Jesus. And in this season, are you willing to give up your pride despite what people may say to you? Are you willing to give up your pride despite your reputation? God ain't talking back to me. Look at somebody and tell them, I got to humble myself. I've got to humble myself. I'm trying to teach over here. You got to humble yourself.
Yeah.
But secondly, you've got to know who Jesus is.
Yeah.
Let's look at 7 through 10. It says, and Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only.
Yeah.
All right.
And my servant shall be healed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For I am a man under authority, having soldiers under me.
Yeah.
And I say to this man, go and he goeth.
Yeah.
And to another, come and he cometh.
Yeah.
And to my servant, do this and he doeth. And when Jesus heard it, he marveled and said to them that followed, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. See, the reason your faith is so low is because we don't have a revelation of who Jesus is. When you lack revelation of Jesus, it makes your walk with him very hard. Jesus does certain things for certain people because they have the revelation of who Jesus is. And if you want to keep it real, we always get mad at certain people just because they are receiving what we wish we could have.
Right.
But let me tell you something. You don't have to get jealous of your brothers and your sisters. All you have to do is just catch the revelation. And you shall have what you need. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Look at your neighbor and tell them, catch the revelation.
Catch the revelation.
The Roman officer understood who Jesus was.
Right.
Jesus said, I will come and heal him. But the Roman officer said, look, Jesus, I'm not about to make you come all the way to my house just to lay hands on
me. Come on.
Just say the word and it's done. See, the problem is, we won't let Jesus take a chill pill.
Come on.
We won't let Jesus chill.
Right.
And see, the problem with today's church is that we make Jesus work too hard.
Oh, yes.
And your lack of revelation of Jesus limits your faith.
It limits
what Jesus can do for you. See, the reason why Jesus could just speak a word and it was done was because the centurion understood the rank of Jesus in the spirit.
Oh, wow.
Let me show you what I'm talking about.
Come on, make it plain.
The centurion understood that him and Jesus was just alike.
All right.
Only thing was, he knew that Jesus was greater.
Right.
He compares his position to Jesus.
Yeah.
He tells Jesus, look, I am a man of authority.
Right.
And I have men under me.
Right. Uh-huh.
And I tell this man, go, and he go.
Right. Yeah.
And my servant, do, and he do it.
Right.
Yeah.
I tell my servant, go do this for me, and he bring it to me.
Yeah.
He knew that Jesus had the power.
Right.
Yeah.
But he also knew that Jesus had more power than he had.
Yeah.
Right.
The Roman officer used to was used to an emperor.
Right.
He knew that all an emperor had to do was speak a word and it was done.
Yeah.
But the Jews only knew that Jesus was a king.
Yeah, yeah.
And the king has to go and make battle.
Right.
He has to command some things.
Yeah.
But an emperor doesn't have to command nothing at all.
Right.
All he has to do is speak a word and it's done. And this morning, Jesus is looking for somebody that will believe him to be that emperor instead of their king. This morning, Jesus is looking for somebody that he can speak one word and that's all to. Some of y'all need to upgrade y'all faith because my God is the God which calleth things which are not. And they're talking back to me. Just look at somebody and tell them all it takes is one word from the Lord and your life will never be the same. Once you believe he's an emperor, your life will never be the same because every demon that's messing with you has to be silenced by the word of the Lord. Therefore, your house is about to be changed. Your money is about to be changed. Your children are about to be changed because God is about to hit your life with the empire of God. Because every knee has to bow. Every tongue has to confess that Jesus is Lord. Look at your neighbor and tell them, the demon's about to quit playing with you. The demon's about to quit playing with you. See, you've got to catch the revelation of who Jesus is.
Right.
Told you I'm quick and I'm done. One more point. You've got to please Jesus with your faith.
Come on now.
Look at your neighbor and tell them, you've got to please Jesus with your faith.
Wow.
Look at 10 through 13. It says, when Jesus heard it, he marveled said to them that followed, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith. No, not in Israel. Yeah. And I say unto you that many shall come from the east and west and shall sit down with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. But the children of the kingdom of God shall be cast out into the outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
Yeah.
And Jesus said unto the centurion, go thy way.
Yeah.
And as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee.
Yeah.
And his servant was healed in the same hour.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
See, when Jesus heard what the Roman officer had to say to him, it made him marvel.
Uh-huh.
It amazed him because he had not seen such faith at all like this.
Wow.
And this morning I've come to ask somebody, does Jesus marvel at your faith?
Oh, wow.
Or is he displeased with your faith? Many times we forget that we can please Jesus with your faith or you can displease him.
Uh-huh.
See, the reason that Jesus isn't really moving for you is because of the lack of faith that is in your life.
Yeah.
Wow.
This is the reason that this situation is tearing you up.
Uh-huh.
See, when you have faith in Jesus, it causes him to move easily in your life.
Yeah.
If you notice in the text, all the man did was present his belief that he can heal the man with the word.
Yeah.
Because he did this, he pleased God.
Yeah.
And because he pleased God, he got his reward. And you've got to have it made up in your mind that without faith, it is impossible to please God. Because he that's coming to God must believe that he is.
Yeah.
And that he is a rewarder of them that seek him diligently.
Amen.
Look at your neighbor and tell him you got to please Jesus with your faith. See, it amazed Jesus because this man wasn't saved and he had this much amount of faith in God while the Jewish people didn't really believe in him at all.
Yeah.
Amazed him because he showed every miracle, sign and wonder to the people that been with him from day one.
Yeah.
People that been in church had seen everything Jesus could do.
Uh-huh.
They had Jesus the whole time, yet Thomas still doubted. Yet the Pharisees still wanted to kill him.
Yeah.
After he done proved to them that he was the Son of God.
That's right.
Yet The Jewish people still asked for a sign.
Yeah.
If he was the son of God. And if you want to keep it 1,000.
Come on now.
If you want to keep it G with me. It sounds just like the church today.
Wow.
Yeah.
People been in church for 50 years.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
But still have no faith in Jesus.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Been in church for 50 years.
Come on, Mason.
Still don't believe that Jesus can do miracles today.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Been in church for 50 years. And still don't believe that Jesus can take care of them.
Yeah.
But this morning I came to see. If there is anybody that will admit that I have been lacking in faith, is there anybody that will repent this morning and tell Jesus, I have made up in my mind that I'm standing on the solid rock of my salvation? Is there anybody this morning that will tell Jesus, I'm believing in you and I'm resisting the devil? Listen, I was watching a gangster movie one day. I'm gonna tell you this, I'm finished. I promise you, I'm finished. In this gangster movie, the man's baby mama got shot by the people, shot and killed by some other gang members. Uh-huh. Made him mad because now he got a son. Uh-huh. That won't have a mother. Uh-huh. And he'll have to raise him by himself.
Uh-huh.
So he went to his homeboys, told them what happened. And his homeboy said, say no more. It's done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Homies did a drive-by. Shot up his baby mama house and his house. Mm. They got shot. And I want to tell somebody, if you put your faith in God, all things are possible.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
You put your faith in God, say no more. Because it's done.
That's right.
Look at your neighbor and tell them it's done. I want to just tell somebody those demons that's been tormenting your life. Jesus is about to do a drive-by in the spirit. Somebody ought to get excited. Because your destiny is about to be loose in Jesus' name. Your finances is about to be loose in Jesus' name. You're going to get excited because the drive-by shooting at the devil just for you. But tell Jesus, you ain't got to do all that. Just say the word and it's done. Tell your neighbor, let Jesus take the shield for you. That's the message.
It's impossible. Say it's impossible.
It's impossible.
You can't. Let me tell you something. You can front in front of us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And dance a little bit. Learn to dance.
Yeah.
Hey, blah, 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 blah. You know, but that don't. Let me tell you something. That don't mean you got a lick of faith. That just means that you are theatrical.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah,
man. That's right.
How do we know that you're theatrical?
Yeah.
Because soon as some trouble come your way, you lose your Hanukkah shutdown. Have I got a witness up in here?
Amen.
You lose your dance. Matter of fact, you don't even come to church no more. My grandmother was here, but what happened to the old church? That even in times of trouble, they drew closer to the church. And they came there saying, trouble in my way. I got to cry sometimes. after a while. I know that Jesus will fix it after a while.
Amen. Amen.
I know it don't seem like it's manifested. I know you didn't ask for it a few times, and it don't seem like it manifested. But man of God just told you, let Jesus take a chill pill. He hugs you.
Yeah, yeah. That's it.
Maybe you ought to go start praying for something else, because he already got that on lock.
That's right.
He already got it on lock. Go start praying for something else. You got bigger fish to fry.
Yeah.
Let him take a chill pill. Why are you trying to figure that? He already worked it out.
That's it.
See, so many of us, we busy trying to say another prayer to keep us from going through the process. You can't pray your way out of the process.
Yes, sir.
The only way you go, the only way, you know what? He already made a way for you to get through what you're going through, but you don't want to go through it. You sit there in the middle of it and cry.
Yeah.
All you gotta do is keep walking. Keep walking through it. And then with it, then, you see, because it requires faith to keep walking. Because the world say you should sit right there and cry about
right.
it.
You're right, Pastor.
Matter of fact, you know what the world really tell you? World tell you, get somebody else. No, matter of fact, devil will send you somebody else. Come here, man of God. You, come here. Devil will send you somebody that's in the same situation as you. You know what you do? Because birds of a feather,
they
flock together.
That's right.
Before long, we just two people, two discouraging people.
Right.
And you know what we're going to do? Hallelujah, we like little minions. And we're looking for somebody just as miserable as us.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We're going to find somebody else. Come here, CJ. Hallelujah. We're going to find somebody else. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
We're going to find somebody else. A bunch of faithless people.
Yeah.
And you know what we're doing? The whole while, you know what we're doing? We're tearing up the church.
Yeah. That's right, Pastor.
Come on now.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And that's where the devil ain't scared of you. Why? Because you're talking loud and you're saying nothing. Do you know one bullet will kill you?
Yes, it will.
Yeah. Anybody know how to shoot a gun? How many bullets it take to kill you?
Just one.
How many bullets it take to kill you, Jay? So all it takes is one. One shot, baby. One prayer will kill your situation. Pray about it. Keep it moving. You know how you can keep it moving? Because you really believe and have faith in two things. One, he heard you. And two, he answered.
That's right. Let's
say that again.
Yeah.
When you really have faith, all it takes is one prayer. Because you'll know that one, he heard you, and two, he answered. Even in the midst of it looking like it's not an answer, even in the midst of it looking like it's not manifested, even in the midst of it of you thinking, he didn't hear me, because all hell is breaking loose. Don't you think? He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. That's what David said. He said, why? David had faith.
Yeah.
David was a man of faith.
Yes,
because he had already seen him do it. So why don't we have faith this morning? You already seen him do it before. Didn't you see him heal you before?
Yes, sir. Amen.
He already took care of your lupus. That's done. He ain't pray about that no more. Done. On to the next prayer. He already took care of your job situation. On to the next prayer. He's still a way out of no way. Have faith. Let him take a chill pill. Have faith that he heard you. Have faith that he already answered.
Glory to God.
I'm just waiting for the manifestation. He already answered it. He says, my will that you prosper even as your soul prospers. Why is that? It's my will that you prosper even as your soul prosper. Watch this. Because we know the devil is always lurking around. But God is telling you just like he told Satan. God is telling Satan just what he told him about Job. You can take that stuff, but you can't take his soul.
Yeah.
So let me tell you this. You can always get some more stuff once you allow your soul to prosper. About stuff.
Yeah.
Get some peace. Pray for some peace in your mind. You get some peace in your mind, you can get some more money. Go, Jackie. Go right about it. Amen. But my back was against the wall, and it looked as if it was all.